हेलो स्टूडेंट, माय सेल्फ पीयूष माथुर फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग, आर्या कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड आईटी, कुकस, जयपुर। माय वीडियो लेक्चर इज बेस्ड ऑन सब्जेक्ट यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैड स्टडीड अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रिकल हीटिंग एंड सम टाइप्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल हीटिंग। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सम मोर टाइप्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल हीटिंग। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, आर्क हीटिंग। आर्क हीटिंग मीन्स करंट फ्लो इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए कंटिन्यूस स्पार्क नोन एज आर्क। इफ द हाई वोल्टेज इज अप्लाइड अक्रॉस एन एयर गैप, द एयर इन द गैप गेट्स आयोनाइज अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोस्टेटिक फोर्सेज एंड बिकम कंडक्टिंग मीडियम। देन करंट फ्लो इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए कंटिन्यूस स्पार्क नोन एज आर्क। दीज आर रिक्वायर्ड वेरी हाई वोल्टेज To establish an arc, very high voltage is required, but very small voltage is sufficient to maintain it across the air gap. So high voltage is covered from by the help of step-up transformer. Now we are going to types of arc heating. There are two types: direct arc heating and indirect arc heating. In last video lecture, we have studied about the direct heating method and indirect heating method. Direct heating means the current flow in the element directly, and the indirect heating means the current flow to the help of by any highly resistive element through the wire, through the cable, and the heat is transferred by the any one type of method such as conduction, convection and radiation. These are the modes of transfer of heat methods. Now we are going to types of arc heating. Firstly, direct arc heating. These are the diagram of direct arc heating. In this diagram, the two electrode is connected to the supply, and there are the charge. The arc is produced between the charge and electrodes. When the supply to the electrode by the help of wire, the arc it produces due to the current, and these arc flow to the charge, and the heat becomes very fast. So these are the very simple method to heated any material. Now we are going to indirect arc heating. In indirect arc furnace, the arc strikes between two electrodes. There are the two electrodes. The arc strike between the two electrodes by bringing momentary in contact, and then withdrawing them heat so developed due to the striking of arc across air gap is transferred to the charge by purely by radiation method, such as example just like sun radiation is coming to the earth, so these arc provide to radiation to the charge. So the material becomes heated. Now we are going to high frequency heating. In high frequency heating method, the electromagnetic energy is converted into the heat energy inside the material. There are two types: induction heating and dielectric heating. Induction heating is also two type: direct core type induction heating and indirect core type induction heating. Now first of all, we have discussed about the induction heating. The induction heating process make the use of current induced by the electromagnetic action in the material to be heated. To develop sufficient amount of heat, the resistance of the material must be low, and power draw is generally we know that the power loss I square R. There are the show diagram by the induction heating. There are the metallic discs, and the copper coil is surrounded by the metallic disc. The heat is produced due to some following factors. There are the primary coil current, the number of turns of the coil, supply frequency, the magnetic coupling between the coil and disc, the high electric resistivity of the disc. When the current flow to the copper coil, the heat developed due to the by the help of electromagnetic action in the material to be heated. To develop sufficient amount of the heat, metals must be low power losses. Now, we are going to types of induction heating. The first of all, the direct core type induction heating. In this heating, there are the two windings, primary winding and secondary winding. It's connected such as like transformer. The core type furnace is essentially a transformer in which the charge to be heated from single turn secondary circuit and is magnetically coupled to the primary by an iron core. The furnace consists of a circular hearth in the form of trough which contains the charge to be melted in the form of annular ring generally. This metal ring is quite large in diameter and is magnetically interlinked with primary winding which is energized from the AC source. These are the primary winding is connected by the single phase AC source and these are the magnetic link from primary to secondary winding and the circular hearth in the form of trough. These are the charge annular or these are the hearth. These are the magnetic link is called iron core. In this method, the magnetic coupling between the primary and secondary is very weak. So it results in high leakage reactance and low power factor. So there in starting we have given to the supply in low frequency to compensate the low power factor and high leakage reactance. So the magnetic coupling between the primary and secondary is very weak, so its result is high leakage reactance and low power factor. When there is no molten metal in the hearth, the secondary becomes open circuited, thereby the cutting of secondary current. Hence to the start of furnace, the molten metal has to be taken in the hearth to keep the secondary as a short circuit. So the short circuit to the hearth, we have maintained the frequency. Now when the current exceeds about the 500 ampere per centimeter square, it will produce a high electromagnetic force in the molten metal. So and the heat, hence adjacent molecules repel each other and they run in the same direction. The ripples may cause the interruption of secondary circuit. This effect is known as pinch effect. So heat is produced by the in the form of when the normal supply is given to the hearth. Now these are the method of direct core type induction furnace. Now we are going to coreless type induction furnace. In this slides we have show the coreless type induction furnace. It is the simple furnace with the absence core. In this furnace the heat is developed in the charge due to eddy current flowing through it. So these are the method of generally indirect induction heating by the help of induction current produced in the form due to eddy current. The furnace consists of refractory or ceramic crucible cylinder in the shape enclosed within a coil that form primary side of transformer. So these are the diagram show, these are the refractory ceramic crucible cylinder. These are the charge. When the supply is given to the primary coil, excited by the alternating flux, and the eddy current is produced in the charge. The result of eddy current is opposite to the induced in the current coil sides. The heat becomes produced due to the eddy current. So the process generally when the primary coil are excited by an alternating source, the flux set up by this coil induce the eddy current in the charge. The direction of the resultant eddy current in a direction opposite to the current in the primary coil. Each current heat the charge to the melting point and then also set up electromagnetic force that produce a string action to the charge. We have already in study in subject machine, the eddy current developed in the any magnetic circuit is WE is proportional to BM square F square. The eddy current losses are depend on this formula. Now we are going to study about dielectric heating. Dielectric heating means non-metallic material such as insulator, such as wood, plastic and china glass are subjected to high voltage alternating field. In above material, atom get stresses and due to interatomic friction caused by the repeated deformation and the rotation of atomic structure by the polarization, the heat is produced. This is known as dielectric loss. The dielectric loss in insulator corresponding to hysteresis loss in ferromagnetic material. This loss is due to the reversal of magnetic or magnetomolecular flow friction. This loss developed in a material that has to be heated. The dielectric loss, just like such a capacitor, there are two plates. The dielectric medium fill in between the two plates. Now we have study about the dielectric heating method, how to calculate the dielectric loss. As there is no perfect conductor, so there is no perfect insulator. All the dielectric material can be represented by parallel combination of resistance and capacitance. So this diagram shows that there are two plates, it's called electrode, is connected to the supply and the dielectric material between two electrodes. When the given supply to the dielectric medium, the dielectric material behave as a RC parallel circuits. So there are the equivalent circuit of dielectric material, there are the resistance, there are the capacitor are connected to the parallel and the current is flow from the supply source. When the supply voltage is given to the circuit, the current is split into two parts. In the resistance we have called IR, in the capacitor we have called capacitor. Now we have calculate the dielectric loss. We have draw a Faraday diagram. There are the Faraday diagram. There is the relation between the current and voltage. These are the voltage are reference. When we have given to the supply the current flow to the resistance, we all know that in previous class in the sum of terms rules of Faraday diagram, the current flow in the resistance is same when the voltage is generally in same phase. When the current flow in the capacitor, the current flow from the voltage above the 90 degree lead, it means that the current 90 degree lead from the voltage due to capacitor, then it means that the voltage lagging from the current. So these are the relation. There are the IC is 90 degree lags the voltage and IR is the same phase of the current. The resultant of IR and IC is we get the I. So these five angles show basically I current we have get by the phasor sum of IR and IC. This phi angle is show the relation between the voltage and current angle, and delta is show the dielectric loss in the material. So the question is how to calculate the dielectric loss in dielectric material. So we know that the power is in any dielectric loss the VI cos phi. So we know that from the relation of Faraday diagram, the IR equals to I cos phi. So IR equals to I cos phi. When we put the value, we know we have calculated the tangent from the Pythagoras formula IR upon IC. So the formula becomes of power loss is V into IC into tangent. When we put the value of IC, there we know that the V upon XC, it's been then voltage upon capacitive reactance. So put the value of these in formula. Now we get V square omega C tangent. We have all know that the omega equals to 2 pi F and the value of capacitor is generally capacitor is epsilon naught epsilon R A upon D. where the epsilon naught is absolute permittivity and epsilon r is relative permittivity. The value of generally absolute permittivity is 8.854 into 10 to power minus 12, and d is basically thickness of plates, and there are the dielectric loss and total loss. Now we have concluded the in this formula